بالتأكيد كما قلت بأن تعز هي من أكثر المناطق أو المدن اليمنية اشتعالا، وما تزال الحرب فيها مستمرة، وأيضا تتعرض تعز إلى حصار خانق ومحاصرة من كل الاتجاهات. بالطبيعة الحال أن العمل أو التحرك في ظل هذه الأجواء هو فيه خطورة كبيرة، وحتى أننا عندما أخرج أو أتحرك من أجل أرصد لا أتوقع بأنني سأعود إلى البيت.
Since 2015, Yemen has been gripped by civil conflict due to fighting between forces loyal to the internationally recognized president, Abed Rabo Mansour Hadi, and those aligned with the Houthi movement.
انتقلنا وزملائي انا وزملائي للموقع الحادث يومها، او زملائي انتقلوا لموقع الحادث ووثقنا بالصوت والصوره والمقابلات مع الضحايا والمدنيين الموجودين.
The national monitors and monitors on the ground very crucial members of our team in OPT in Yemen, Iraq and elsewhere in any conflict zone. It is important to have the right people on the ground to report and verify information.
Sahir Amer and Mohammed Hakimi compile this information, which is later used in reports to governments, NGOs, and others interested in what's happening in the country.
All those things that we are doing is to help those people who got injured to make their voices go to the world, so everyone can know what exactly happens in our country.
Yemen currently has 12 UN human rights monitors documenting violations across this vast country under harsh conditions.
في البداية عندما كنا نقول أن رئاسة المفوضية السامية لحقوق الإنسان كانوا يبتسموا امرأة تبحث عن حقوق الإنسان سواء من في السلطة أو المواطنين العاديين. الآن عندما تقول لهم رئاسة المفوضية السامية لحقوق الإنسان ينظرون إليك باحترام ويعرفون أن لك دور كبير.
What's impressive is that actually for all of them, their commitment kind of predated their professional engagement. This is something that people really have to know about our monitors. They don't look at this as a job. Actually, I can vouch for the fact that they are actually deeply committed to human rights.
And monitoring has made a difference. Recently, the UN Human Rights Council created a group of eminent experts to carry out a comprehensive examination of all alleged violations and abuses of international human rights committed by all parties to the conflict in Yemen, and where possible, to identify those responsible. They begin their work this year in 2018.